Sesame Street was one of my favorite cartoons to watch when I was a child. Kermit the...
And I'm like, I'm gonna do another one, because... Let's see, the Harley Quinn one that I just uploaded... It just got uploaded. I'm gonna try to not do... I'm gonna say what I said in the Batman one I did, like that one up there from 6 months ago. I'm gonna try and stop doing reactions. I'll do a reaction to Slacker's yeah or nay video. I'll do a Mr. Nightmare, but I don't think I can do anything else. I got copywritten twice. I don't want it to happen again. So just to be on the little safe side, you know? Just to be on the little safe side. This is Franklin, last episode. Let's see, it's rated T. Great. Franklin, an old cartoon that used to air on Nick Jr. back in the late 90s and early 2000s, based on the old children's books by Brenda Clark and Paulette Bourgeois? Bourgeois? I don't know, Bourgeois, why not? It was pretty typical kids, so... Talking animals, a bit of comedy, and learning some life lessons at the end of the episodes. Remember, I used to watch it all the time as a kid. I always had a love for animals. That's probably what hooked me on it way back then. Yet the love I used to have for this harmless kid show all died in me after I saw it. I love Franklin. I don't know how something so unholy, so gruesome could be shown, and be allowed to be shown on television. I've heard of things like this before. These lost episodes, you may all pass them off as a normal creepypasta story, but let me tell you, it is indeed real. I pray none of you ever see this vile distortion of children entertainment, yet the images of what I saw haunt me in my nightmares. Perhaps if I tell you about it, I get some closure and warn you about the lost episode of Franklin. I suppose it'll start back with how I can about... I suppose I'll start with how I can about witnessing... I suppose I'll start with how I can about witnessing this program. My little sister has this babysitting job certain days for the week, and usually she doesn't get home till 6:30 or 7, yet when she does, she has to do homework since she can't do it while watching some little kids. Also, she had to use the computer for it, which so happens to be in my room. Thus, I'm banished from the living room to the living room while she does her schoolwork. There I was. Just me and my TV. I searched for a guide a bit and looking for anything worth a darn. What's the point of getting extra channels from Fox if there is anything worth watching? But I'd be here for a while. My sister had to do a project, so she'd definitely be in there for over an hour, at least I bet. And boy, would I have won that bet big time. It was around 9:30 at night now. I asked when she'd be done when we get the vague answer. I'm almost there. Yeah, almost halfway there, I thought to myself. Thus, I was back to the TV. As I scrolled through the channel, something popped up at me. There it was. Franklin. For the show got canceled, I said to myself. It must have been some type of special, I assumed. That's why it was on so late. Call nostalgia or call laziness or for not bothering to see if there was anything else better on. I decided to watch it. The episode started off normally enough. The opening "Hey, it's Franklin" song. You got say it sounded a bit dorky to me now, but whatever. Then things got real messed up. The episode started off with an image of Woodland, along with Franklin and all his family and friends. It's a cloudy day, almost like it's about to rain. Seeing the fades to all the parents and the children, animals or so, outside somewhere. Franklin's parents, Bear's parents, Beaver's parents, etc., etc. Everyone's missing were Fox. Or Mr. Fox and Mr. Owl. Also, there were no children other than Badger. Bear's little sister and Franklin's little sister. Also, Badger, who usually just has to use crutches and get around because he has super palsy, is now in a wheelchair and in a broken arm. Everybody was crying. I don't understand why, but suddenly the scene changes and we're shown a normal sunny day along with a road. A school bus drives and then soon the inside of it. Franklin and all his friends along with their teacher, Mr. Owl, and the bus driver, Mr. Fox. Mr. Owl's talking about a museum field trip, the class is going on. All the students are excited. Of course, in their own ways. Bears wonder what type of food there'd be, as usual. Beaver's being a snotty know-it-all, claiming he knows everything about the place like he always does. And Fox wanted to see a dinosaur exhibit. And of course, Franklin was wondering what the whole place would be like. Yet, Mr. Fox begins to clench his chest in pain. The bus swerves a bit as he starts to gasp for air. He's having a heart attack. Dad, Fox cries out in worry. A few of the other children scream in terror. Mr. Owl gets up and tries to get to the bus driver. Mr. Fox falls off the driver's seat. The bus drives off the road down a steep hill. Mr. Owl falls to the floor of the bus and cries in pain. He gets up and still got a pencil in his left eye. Perhaps a fall in someone's book bag. Bear pukes in horror of this. Right on Franklin, who then freaks out and gets out of his seat, only then to crash into Mr. Owl and Mr. Fox. As he does this, his arm hits the steering wheel, causing the bus to turn off over and over as it goes down the hill. In the bus, the children are crashing into each other, and everything in the bus, broken glass and windows flying into the bodies all over. Snow got sent flying out of the open window. His head was crushed to bits, with a shard of glass going through his neck. Eventually the bus crashes into some trees and at the bottom of the hill. Some of the cars of the bus, glass pieces everywhere. Almost everyone's bodies bent was unnatural ways, the whole 9 yards. A few seconds later, a bloody, battered, bruised Badger crawls out of the bus, only to look back and watch it burst into flames and explode moments after. The scene goes back to the parents and a few kids who I now see are all out in a cemetery, mourning the loss of their family and friends. The episode ends after that. Yet in the credits, which would normally set up part of the episode, instead showed a tombstone afterwards. R.I.P. Franklin and friends. And that's the story. I've heard this, but reading it now, I kind of like it. I don't know why. It's just one of my favorite ones. I don't really know. I kind of like this one. This one was pretty good. I don't care what anyone says. It's a real good story. For a lot of episode series, I kind of like it. Now, if you'll excuse me, my Twitter and Twitch will be in my description. And now, it's time to eat my dinner. And play some golf. And maybe listen to some music, who knows? Let's see what we got here. That's some Weird Al Yankovic. I can't play that because copyright. So I'm going to find a golf game. I'm going to eat my dinner. What time is it? It's 5:23. around like 8:30 or 9 or so. I'm gonna go to bed, get up at like 5 a.m. or so. Hey, the Satter Eater. Alright. I love the Satter Eater. That's it. My Twitter and Twitch are in my description. If anybody cares, I'm planning on streaming Batman again one of these days. So get ready for that. If you have any story requests for horror stories, just let me know on my Twitter.